Please be seated. Welcome, everyone. We have come together today at the invitation of Michael and Elizabeth to share the joy of their wedding. This outward celebration, we shall see and hear, is an expression of the inner love and devotion they have in their hearts. Marriage is a supreme sharing of experience and an adventure in the most intimate of human relationships. It is the joyous union of two people whose comradeship and mutual understanding have flowered into romance. Today, Michael and Elizabeth proclaim their love and commitment to the world, and we gather here to rejoice with them and for them in the new life they now undertake together. The joy we feel now is a solemn joy, because the act of marriage has many consequences, both social and personal. Marriage requires love, a word that we often use in Vegas and sentimentality. We may assume that love is some rare and mystical event, when in fact it is our natural state of being. So what do we mean by love? When we love, we see things other people do not see. We see beneath the surface through the qualities which make our love special and unique. To see with loving eyes is to know your beauty. And to be loved is to be seen and known as we are known to know others. One who loves us gives us a unique gift, a piece of ourselves, but a piece that only they can give us. The secret of love and marriage is similar to that of religion itself. It is the emergence of the larger self. It is defining one's life by losing it. Such is the privilege of husband and wife, to be each himself, herself, and yet another, to face the world strong with the courage of two. To make this relationship work, therefore, it takes more than love, it takes trust. To know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It takes dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and to grow, even when it is difficult to do so. And it takes faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. While love is a natural state of being, these other qualities are not as easy to come by. They are not a destination, but a journey. The true art of married life is in this inner spiritual journey. It is a mutual enrichment, a give and take between two personalities, a mingling of two endowments which diminishes neither, but enhances both. Michael and Elizabeth, you will soon have a relationship pledge between each other and agree that you will commit to one another throughout your lives. The most beautiful example of this partnership is the marriage relationship. You will have committed here today to share the rest of your lives with each other. Today, this relationship is symbolized for the form of these two individual containers of sand. One, representing you, Michael, in all that you were, in all that you are, in all that you will ever be. The other container representing you, Elizabeth, in all that you were, in all that you are, in all that you will ever be. As these two containers of sand poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into their individual containers, so will your marriage be. Yet, it is vitally important to remember that there are always really two in marriage. Each with his or her own desires, yearnings, dreams, and wishes. And this must be respected and responded to with great love, with great compassion, and with genuine tenderness. May your union be forever blessed. you take Elizabeth to be your wife, to live together in God's will in the holy bonds of marriage. We promise in the presence of God before these witnesses to love and comfort her, honor and cherish her, in sickness and in health, in prosperity and adversity, forsaking all others till death do part us.
I do.
Elizabeth.